Hello everyone, welcome to another video. Today we're going to talk a bit more about my sewing book collection. By popular request, some of you have asked to see just what I own, what's good out there, because you know there's a lot of sewing books out there right now in English, and we're so lucky to live in a time where all this information is right there at your fingertips through the Great Wide Web. But I am still a lover of books, so I have 7 of my own books right here to share with you, and I will talk you through every single one of them. And I think it's a good look at both beginner technique books as well as books with patterns already given to you in them. And we actually even have a look at both Asian style pattern books as well as American / Western style pattern books, and there are some differences between them. Of course, if you have further requests about the sewing series, please leave it down below for me in the comment section. I've really been enjoying making these videos, and you seem to really enjoy watching them as well. Some of you, you know, are really excited because you used to sew and this just feels all very nostalgic. Others of you are curious about sewing but aren't quite ready to jump in with both feet yet. Well, hopefully these videos of mine, along with my project updates and my own progress, will really inspire you to take up sewing. So let's get on and talk about some of these beautiful books. I'm going to start off with books about sewing techniques and then move on to those about actual patterns and come with patterns. This first one that you see here is called Me and My Sewing Machine. It is a great beginner's guide, a reference book really to basic sewing techniques that you will use everywhere. I love that the catalog of techniques is very complete, but there's nothing frivolous. Like, there's not a single technique that you will not encounter in your process to learning how to sew. I love that there's both photographs as well as written text, because you know, sometimes it's hard to go abstract. This book, called Hand Sewn, is wonderful. Again, it is a catalog of sewing techniques. Of course, this time, however, it is about hand sewing. It has everything from classic tailoring techniques to embroidery and just little finishing touches that you can do with just some thread and needle. You know, I really believe that a hand sewing garment should not look sloppy and it should not look cheap. People should look and admire your garment and say, wow, what a beautiful piece. I love the little details you put in here. And it should even be better than those that you buy out, and not something that you can replicate easily off the rack. This is a great book again for beginners because it also comes with photographs. The Vogue sewing book I have here is the updated version of a true sewing classic. I will tell you right now, this is not for someone who is a beginner. Unless you plan on going to fashion school or studying tailoring, you probably won't find this book very easy to read. It has a lot of precise and excellent detailed technical information, but it's hard to get through because there's a lot of text and not enough pictures in my opinion. There are some illustrations, but really hard to just get the information that you need, and you probably won't have as much fun reading it. So save this one until you're very ready. Next, we're moving on to books which also have sewing patterns as well as step-by-step project instructions. This first one from Colette is, again, very beautiful. I have a soft spot for vintage-inspired patterns. I collect a lot of them, originals from the 40s, 50s, and 60s. So I bought this book only recently. This is a little bit of a mix between how to get your basic techniques as well as projects. So the projects really help you practice those techniques, and this book actually comes with individual patterns to help you try those techniques out. It also includes details like how to make a muslin and do a first fitting, because having a perfect fit is really important to a beautiful finished garment. Again, I'm showing you some of the projects that are available in this book, and it actually comes with full-size patterns, which we will see in just a moment. I really think the Colette Sewing Handbook is a great mix between technical information and let's just get a project done and, you know, so we can wear it. So I think there's a high success rate with something like this. Again, all of the pages are beautifully illustrated and very detailed. And throughout the book, she will go back and talk to you about selecting the right fabric, what are the differences. So you do get a good chunk of technical knowledge when you go to the fabric store and make, you know, your options. You'll notice that with this book also, each project is followed by a full set of instructions on how to create that particular piece of item. For example, the truffle dress right here, it goes into step-by-step detail. So it's a combination of instruction book, project book, technique books, and just general background sewing knowledge, which is, again, I think, very easy to access for a beginner or someone who is a bit more advanced, or if you just love the sewing patterns that I've shown here. Now, most project-based sewing books that you will be able to buy out on the market come with patterns in maybe 4 to 5 different ways. This one comes with full-size printed patterns, which I think is the easiest for a beginner. So I'll show you what they look like right here. They're right in the back of the book, and they come as regular printed tissue, like how you would buy any commercial pattern. The pieces are not printed in an overlapping way, so each piece is individual, and of course, it's multiple-sized on one piece. So you just take your own measurements and cut as you need to, or of course, if you want to preserve the original, you can always use a tracing wheel and some copying paper to trace out a correct sizing for you so you can use other sizing on different occasions. Now, the Berta Style Sewing Handbook is another project-based sewing book, but it's done a little bit differently. Again, it has all the basics, like teaching you how to choose the right fabric, how to lay out your patterns for cutting purposes, and how to choose the right materials and tools that you will need, as well as sizing. Each project is laid out with a basic sewing pattern and then updated with details on how to put a twist to that to make it your own and really change up the entire garment. So if you are a creative type who like to really do a little extra DIY on top of just making the actual clothing, this might be one for you. But you will notice that although there are step-by-step instructions following every single project, they are a bit harder to read. I find that the photographs work a lot better in, say, the Colette book versus this one. And also, you need to do a lot more reading. Here's a general layout of a single top that can be made into different variations. So it does give you some creative ideas, but again, harder to follow, in my opinion, for an absolute beginner. There's a lot more text and a lot less illustrations. You can see I've sticky marked a few of the items that I really like, although I have not actually sewn up any of them, and that's a little to do with the way that the pattern is given to you, which I will show you right now. All the pattern pieces, as well as all the sizes, are printed on only a couple pieces of very large paper in an overlapping format. This means that you will not be able to cut out the pieces directly, as you will cut into another pattern piece. You have to make a copy of it before you can use it. This format is very popular with a lot of European pattern books, as well as Japanese pattern books, I found. And speaking of Japanese sewing books, they are some of my favorites because I grew up with them from my mother. This one is called Feminine Wardrobe, and it is actually an English translation of an original Japanese sewing book. You'll notice that their style is very different from those of American books and even European sewing books as well. It has a very natural, loose, flowing type of look, and it uses a lot of linens and more organic cottons and things like that. It's just a particular style that the Japanese are known for, especially when it comes to crafting. I'm showing you here some of the different styles that they offer, and this is again a project-based sewing book, which means it will have a couple of projects for you along with instructions and the pattern pieces out in the back so you can make these exact garments. Now have a look. These are the instructions. Each garment has about 1.5 page and sometimes 2 pages of instructions, but not laid out like the other books. There are usually multiple sets of instructions and steps on each illustration, and the text instruction is really minimal. So you really have to know what you're doing in terms of what goes first and what happens next. Again, this is not something I would recommend if you have never worked with Japanese patterns before, or if you don't have someone guiding you throughout the process for the first time.
Here, I am actually showing you the pattern pieces that come along with this book. And again, it is exactly the same as the previous Berta Style Sewing Handbook. You know, this format is great if you are familiar with the tracing process and following lines. But if you're not, I would recommend that you start with regular commercial patterns before you go on to this, and unless you have someone helping you. Casual Sweet Clothes is another English translation of a Japanese sewing book, but I think the patterns are a bit more modern, still with a little bit of the Japanese aesthetic though. I love pretty much every single design in this book, but again, I have not had the chance to make any, especially because you gotta trace out the pattern pieces yourself. But they're all very easy to wear, and there are a couple of these translated books floating around on Amazon. If you want to have a look, if you just click on one link, it'll link you to another and another and another. You really have to be familiar with how to read these instructions though, as well as how to read, you know, how much fabric you need and the way that it's laid out. The actual project pattern pieces are printed in the same format as the previous book, which is again popular for Japanese books.
Yay, you've made it to the end. I hope that you loved the whole talk through. It took a little extra time to film, but I really want to get you knowledgeable about what types of books are out there, which ones might be good for you, and just have a peek at the inside of the books, right? Again, let me know which book was your favorite and any of them really spoke to you. Are you going to try and get some of them? I think almost every single one of these off of Amazon, actually with the exception of one, I bought it in a store, but everything can be found on Amazon. That's where I buy all of my sewing books. I have a whole list that's ever growing. What I love to do usually is actually go to the library first and check out the crafting section. Sometimes it will update with new sewing books and I'll flip through and borrow them and see if it's something that's really worthwhile keeping in my collection. You don't want repeats of similar content books. You want variety and you want books that really are a good reference for you while you are sewing and learning and progressing. So happy sewing, have a wonderful week, and I will see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.